The goal of this Franklin project at the Aspen Institute that Elliot Gerson and Walter and General McChrystal came back from commanding troops in Afghanistan and Iraq and said, for the first time in history, less than 1% of Americans are serving in our nation's military, leading to the complacent assumption that serving the country is somebody else's job. Right. And called for large-scale civilian national service. And there are people like Mackenzie Moritz, who were in Teach for America for 8 years, now working day in and day out, to make the realization of a service year for every 18 to 28-year-old a common expectation and opportunity in America, and a civic rite of passage that gives you this big transformative experience that changes your life trajectory forever. And I think what's interesting related to this conversation is that we're actually working with Lumina to look at how a person's service year experience at City Year or Teach for America or Habitat for Humanity, or if LaShauntaye Moore comes in time in the Earth Conservation Corps, how that actually translates into a pipeline to employment. So imagine doing that service year and then getting college credit. So let's say you're in a youth conservation corps and you're also taking online courses on environmental stewardship. And at the end of your service year, you get course credit, college you want to go to for that service year, making college more affordable, hopefully college completion more common, and then an entryway into a job. We're also looking at how do you translate that service year into a credential that employers value. Mm-hmm. Right now, if you serve in the Peace Corps like Maureen Conway did, she would actually have a hiring preference in the federal government. That's quite an incentive to get people to do service in the first place, but then it's a pipeline to something. National service cannot be a dead-end street. And so I think what's compelling about the Franklin Project is this vision that we'll get a million young people opportunities every single year on par with the million who are in active duty in our nation's military. But then that will translate into a pipeline of getting to and through college and then into jobs that match the very skills within which you've served. And interestingly, and I know it's about all, our vision is for all, but these opportunity youth, the disconnected youth, the 6.7 million 16 to 24-year-old who Melody Barnes and Monique and so many at Aspen are working so hard to do so much for every day, 70% of them said that they wanted to serve their country, and only 3% are. And that's like a generation of idealism and talent needlessly lost or pushed.